Hey, so what's up guys, welcome to Ishan's Biker Mania. So you have extra cauliflower and don't know what to do with it, so that's why we'll be making Gobi 65. For making it is very easy, so let's start. So guys, for making our Gobi 65, the first step, we have to take our cauliflower and I've cut it into florets, flower shaped. And then in that, we'll add about 6 cups of hot water. So guys, once you add a hot water, in that we'll add about 1 teaspoon of salt and then let it sit there for 6 minutes. So guys, it's been about 6 minutes and now we'll drain off the hot water. So guys, once you drain off all the hot water, in that we'll add about 1 teaspoon of red chili powder, half a teaspoon of turmeric, about 1/4 teaspoon of asafoetida, which is hing. In that we'll add our garam masala, about 1/4 teaspoon. Then we'll add our chaat masala. We'll add about 1/4 teaspoon of cinnamon powder, 1 tablespoon of ginger paste, about 2 tablespoons of yogurt, half a teaspoon of coriander powder. Then in that we'll add our rice flour and we'll add our corn flour. Once you add both of that, we'll add our coriander, then we'll add our curry leaves and then juice of half a lemon, and then we'll mix it well. So guys, once your gobi, which is your cauliflower, is perfectly coated, at that point of time, we'll take a pot and add our oil. I have taken about 250 ml of oil because I have to deep fry it and it is already hot. So in that, we'll add our perfectly coated gobi. Just look at this. And now it's time to fry it. We'll add it into our hot oil. Goes. So guys, once you add your first batch of gobi, we will let it cook until it gets crispy golden brown. So guys, it's been 4.5 minutes and just look at this beauty. It's perfectly golden brown and crispy. And now we will drain the excess oil out of it. Just look at this. Onto a kitchen towel. So guys, once your gobi has been fried, at that point of time, in a different saucepan, we'll add about 3 tablespoons of oil. So guys, once your oil is hot, in that we'll add our cumin seeds, which is jeera. In that, we'll add our chopped garlic. With that, we'll add our ginger. And then take a spoon and mix it. So guys, once you see our ginger and garlic is golden brown, in that, we'll add about 2 tablespoons of yogurt. And guys, in the yogurt, we'll add 2 red chilies. We'll break it Then we'll add it. I'll mix it properly. So guys, once you see our yogurt is bubbling up like this, in that we'll add our fried gobi, which is our gobi 65, just made. Push it in and we'll mix it properly. And guys, in the gobi, the final moment, we'll add a pinch of salt. And then just for garnishing, we'll add some coriander. And then, we'll mix it up. We will dry roast it for about 1.5 minutes, and your gobi 65 is ready. So guys, finally, our gobi 65 is ready. Just look at this. And now, time for the taste test. My favorite part. So crispy. There it goes. The flavors of all the masalas are so damn aromatic. They're jumping onto my mouth. This super crispy. Look at this. So guys, you have come to an end of today's session. Please don't forget to subscribe my channel. If you have any questions, you can always ask me through any of my social media accounts, and I'll see you on next time. Goodbye.